then, without any further ado, thanks for joining in, guys. Welcome to the live from Talk Code with Santosh, and today we have the part 2 of Freelancer's Life, and we'll start with a few questions, and then we'll go ahead. Okay, so the first question is, which programming language should I learn in 2021 to earn a lot in the upcoming years? So, I don't think you have to concentrate on programming part, like on a particular language. Let's say if maybe in 10 years there is something else coming up better than Python, then we have to definitely switch to Python, right? When the Java guys were trained so hard, and they never thought that Java is the next biggest thing, and nothing else would come unbeat Java, and there is something called as Python. Now it is coming overtaking Java, and there are several other languages which are competing Python as well, but it is not pretty much evolved, or the community has been not yet developed, like Kotlin is the upcoming language, but there is still people need to adopt Kotlin, but the widespread is Python. So I don't think you have to stick to some language. Better than you can stick to some kind of technology. Let's say if you're a web developer, learn the in and out of web development, so that will be easier for you to take up something in the future. When there are a lot of companies require a lot of languages, and even different projects require a different language skill set, and that is the difference. So you language or a technology that will be more easier, you will have a wide area of working experience when you choose some technology. If you use Python is, you can use it for anything, but for specific, let's say Python can do game development as well, but there is something called as Unity, which is dedicated for it, and we use C# to do it. So there are specific kind of things where you don't specialize in everything. You need to focus on one thing and be better at it. So I don't think you stick to particular programming language will take you or give you a lot of money. So that is the next thing. So if you want to learn a lot of money, then I think cybersecurity is next biggest thing, and you will definitely in cybersecurity you have a lot to learn, and it is difficult to learn as well. So that is nothing for that question. So if you have any questions, feel free to post that in the Q&A, so that we'll take that up. So the next question that we are going to take up is, why do most students, I think you can see that question as well. So why do most students prefer to learn programming online instead of a college professor? So, I prefer that way, learning from a college professor or learning from a tutorial itself, like someone teaching you something. It doesn't suit for me, and most people don't like it. So when you this is for a beginner stage, when you are into programming, or if you are into some new technology, you need someone to guide. So once you start programming, and once you learn a particular tech stack, let's say if you are into web development with Python, you might have learned Flask. So once you start learning Flask, and once you are start building projects on Flask, if you want to move to Django, which is a full sketched framework for web development, it will be more easier for you to understand by yourself without a teacher or without a professor to assist you in teaching that. Since you have the basics of Flask, it will be more easier for you to switch to Django or any other web framework. Since you have the basics right, it will be more you can switch a little bit faster, and you'll understand those concepts in a better way than others. So I think professor, you need that when you are when you are at the initial stage of developing a problem, initial stage of learning something, you need a professor who has to teach you something, and you have to understand it and keep asking questions, and then getting your questions clarified with them is the most important thing. And the questions are n number, the questions keep on coming when you start something. And even if you start something new, then you cannot even ask questions to the forum, since nobody hasn't worked on that particular tech stack. So if you want to learn by professor, and it is really difficult these days to find a good mentor, and you know, that's another part of being self-taught. So teaching yourself is the must-have skill in these days. So let me move on. So we have the next question. So I didn't expect this one from you, man. Okay, fine. So how can an ECE student be successful as a computer science student? You know, how do I excel in coding along with to be exact, no, you cannot excel with ECE curriculum. So what are the other websites or apps which can be helpful to learn coding from scratch? So let's say I am an ECE grad, so it'll be more easier for me to answer this. So when you take up ECE and if you are passionate about computer science like me, then it is really hard for you to learn coding stuff, since nobody is going to teach you, and in the curriculum you will have like 2 to 3 papers on programming and rest others will be on hardware part, so related to electronics and communication. So it is difficult for you to switch between the morning you will be from maybe 9 to 5 or 9 to 4 you will be studying a ECE curriculum, and then you have to utilize your maybe 7 to 8 hours studying computer science concepts and implementing those. It is really difficult, and for a computer science guy it is pretty much the same. You learn something in the morning, you practice at the practice at the hostel or at the home. That is pretty much the basic thing that you can do. But for a ECE guy or for any other branch, for an example, it is difficult for them to adapt to this kind of scenario. Like you have to study something in the morning different, and you have to come home or come to hostel very different. So that is really hard. But once you get the basics right, once you get the programming basics right, you can easily build up on what are the basics that you have, and then you can build some projects around that, and you can participate in hackathons, and you can grow your own portfolio, and then that will be more easy for you to getting a job. So learning resources and excellent coding in with ECE curriculum, no man. Yeah, I don't think there is no way to excel with current ECE curriculum. It's not possible. So for the resources, I highly recommend going to Geeks for Geeks. It is, you have a ton of things there. You search anything over there, you will get the code snippets. You can copy paste and you can edit, or you can understand by heart and you can edit those and put it in your project. So that is it. And then you have Stack Overflow, Stack Exchange, and there are tons of open source community available. You can use GitHub forums or GitHub issues. You can look forward, and if you have any doubts in the packages, and I think GitHub is pretty much the platform to look for those kind of bugs or bug fix. And for apps, I don't think apps are pretty much helpful in coding. If you have a, I think if you are starting with coding, you must have a laptop. So I don't think you don't have a laptop when you started coding. No, it's no way. So I highly recommend Geeks for Geeks. And then what you can do is, if you are into web development, I think most of them are widespread. You can read the documentations as it. So I think documentations pretty much tell you everything. When documentation comes up, like if you take Django, they have a pretty good documentation of everything. When from URL redirecting to WebSocket channels, you have pretty much everything covered over there. So it will be more helpful for you if you go through the documentations. So I think that's it for today. So thanks guys for joining in. So if you have any questions, please feel free to post that. We'll answer those and then we will close this live. I'll wait for a few more minutes for the questions to come in, and then we'll close this session. Yeah, I don't think we have any questions today. I think Sunday is a difficult day for you to join in. I think maybe we have to shift it to another day. I thought most people will, they have their college thing going on in the morning and they won't be able to join in. I think Saturday will be fine, right? Not sure. Saturday will be a good day. Okay, fine. Then we'll close the session. Thank you guys for joining in. Take care. Stay safe. Next week, the same time. join in. Thanks guys. Take care. Bye bye.